Hello all. In continuation to the concept of media planning that we had seen in the last video class, today we'll be discussing a totally different topic, a new topic, marketing information system. Now, before we move on to the concept of marketing information system, I would like to share a thought without digressing much from the topic. It is just in terms of the hard times that we are going through. There are a lot of untoward happenings that we hear around us, that we are listening to, and there are some news which saddens us, and maybe that makes us a little more anxious. And although despite all this anxiety, for people who are always ready to look at the brighter side, there are a lot of things which are positive around us. One thing which I would like to highlight is the level of pollution that has substantially come down, and also the skies are getting clear. The air is fresh, and then a lot of initiatives from the part of the government in order to support for students. If I'm talking about the support that is being offered by the government for the student, includes the Ministry of HRD offering access to more than 3 lakh books, absolutely free of cost. And also corporate is also in the forefront in order to support us during this time of lockdown. So one news which I happened to hear yesterday is regarding a course, 15-day course that is being offered by TCS, which will help you prune your soft skills, presentation skills. So a lot of corporate are coming to the forefront with such initiatives. So I just leave a thought with you. Just make use of this opportunity. Look at the brightest side. Now, as a person who is trying to share knowledge with you, I'm exploring on different ways of how to effectively reach across to you through the online platform. Similarly, as students trying to imbibe knowledge, probably this is one time when you should leverage on the opportunity of using more of the online platform for knowledge acquisition and knowledge dissemination. So learn, make use of the platforms, online platforms effectively, and along with it, do something for your self-development, do something to boost immunity. Now there are several apps which are being offered free, which were earlier paid. During this lockdown period, it is offered to you free, health apps, yoga apps. So make use of that. Do something for your self-development, pursue your hobbies, explore your interest, and connect with your schoolmates, school buddies, college buddies. So make use of this time effectively. Let's do it together. So with this thought, I would like to move on to the topic of marketing information system. So in a concept of marketing information system, we'll be covering concept of marketing information system in today's class. We will also look on to the components of marketing information system. So the concept of marketing information system. Marketing information system consists of people, equipment, procedures to gather, sort, analyze, evaluate, and distribute needed timely, accurate information to marketing decision makers. Now, MIS, the concept, let us try to understand the concept of MIS, delineate this particular definition. Now, the first keyword here, people. Now, in marketing information system consists of people. Now, when we say people, whom are we talking about? It could include the stakeholders of the organization, which includes definitely the most important stakeholder being customer, then supplier or the vendors, then financial partners, financial institutions, marketing intermediaries or channel partners. These are some of the people that are involved in the marketing information system. Equally important are the researchers who help company undertake surveys and gather valuable information in the form of research. So the next keyword in the definition is equipment. Now, what do you mean by equipment? Now, this reminds me of Nielsen Research. I'm sure you'd have heard of this particular organization. Now, what is Nielsen Research famous for? TV ratings, TRV ratings. That is one area where Nielsen Research is prominent, is popular for. So what Nielsen Research did is, in order to understand the household viewing habits as to which programs they frequently watch, they have introduced a device, an equipment that is called the people meter. People meter, it was attached to the television house, television sets of the different household with their prior permission. And this people meter used to record the programs or the frequency with which different programs were watched, what is the duration for which different programs were watched, which naturally gave an understanding of the viewing habits of that particular household. So all equipment in marketing information system includes equipments like the people meter that we just discussed about, which will help collect data, analyze, interpret, make some meaningful information out of it. Marketing information system also includes procedures. Now, what do you mean by procedures? Procedures could include a survey that is conducted, a research process that is undertaken in order to understand, maybe, let's say, what is the vibe of the market like? What is the customer satisfaction? What is the customer preference for a particular brand? So, customer attitude. These are some of the examples of procedures undertaken under the marketing information system. And all this will facilitate giving timely and accurate information for what our meaning or concept of marketing information is complete only when this particular information that has been derived with the help of people, equipment and procedures is ultimately facilitating the decision-making process. So this is what is meant by marketing information system. Next, we move on to the components of marketing information system. So marketing information system, we just saw the concept of marketing information system. It is to facilitate decision making. So that is the most important function that is being performed by marketing information system. Now, there are four main components in marketing information system, namely internal reporting system, then the marketing research system, marketing intelligence system, marketing decision support system. These are the four integral parts of the marketing information system, which in turn is being affected by the marketing environment. And this, all the four systems collectively is going to influence the levels of various decisions at various levels of management. So let's clearly understand the four main components of marketing information system. Now, the first component being the internal sources. Now, what constitutes internal sources? What we just spoke about in the beginning of the class, the stakeholder opinion, information. Now, when you talk about opinion of the stakeholders, whom are we referring to? Customers. So customers, vendors, vendor information is pivotal to the organization. And a lot many aspects regarding the functioning of the business, the process, everything could be understood in terms of the interaction the organization would have with the customer based on customer opinion or customer reviews that are provided. Then vendor information. Now another stakeholder is again the financial partners. What is the financial position? That is another internal part of the internal system. How much credit is the organization on? What is the financial standing of the organization? All these are part of the internal system. So I hope the first component is clear, internal system. Now the second component is the external source, which is primarily the marketing intelligence. Now it is not just marketing intelligence, it also includes the databases. Now when you're talking about the external sources, one aspect is the database. It could be a paid one or a non-paid one. Now, non-paid database, I'm sure you know the answer to it. So yes, you thought it right. It is the surveys or some of the opinion surveys or some of the census that are being conducted. So which is available free of cost. Now, the paid ones include some platforms, some facilities like the Lexis, or which is being initiated by organizations, by the corporate. So databases. Now, marketing intelligence. What constitutes marketing intelligence? Marketing intelligence is in terms of what is the understanding of the market scenario. Now, understanding the market scenario, there is one major part of marketing intelligence, which is competitor information, environment scanning, environment scanning in order to understand what were the actions performed by your competitor of late. So based on the competitor action, suitable analysis and interpretation is done and decision making is made. So environment scanning. And another interesting concept I would like to mention with reference to marketing intelligence is garbology. Now, garbology may not be ethical if it is done hidden, if the actual objective is hidden. But then if it is done with not in a company setting, which means in the competitor environment, if it is not done in the competitor environment, garbology is considered ethical, which means you are just trying to decipher the trash left behind by your competitor. Trash means what were your competitors up to. You're understanding what your competitors were up to in the recent past. So that's marketing intelligence. I'll just repeat the concept of marketing intelligence once again. Marketing intelligence is understanding what is happening around the market, the external environment, primarily the competitor. What has been your actions of your competitor, which could be effectively understood through the environment scanning technique as well as garbology. Looking onto the trash of your left behind by your competitor. Another aspect of external sources, syndicated research. Now, we just spoke about Nielsen research. Nielsen research is one very good example. What did I tell you? Nielsen research is into television ratings. So, offering data with respect to television ratings. That is the role being played by Nielsen research. Now, another example I'll give you, JD Power. You know what industry they are into? Automobile rating. Automobile rating is being done by JD Power. So such syndicated research into certain niche area, which is again a part of external source of information. So we said the concept of database, which is paid or unpaid, under external source of information. We have also talked about syndicated research, and then we have also talked about marketing intelligence, which primarily includes a competitor for which garbology or environment scanning can be adopted. So the third component of marketing information system is marketing research system. So what research is being undertaken? So there are some information that will not come to you immediately. So where the organization will have to invest on research, conduct a survey or opinion poll, and then collect data, analyze and interpret the data in order to gather meaningful information out of it. So that will be carried out under this particular component, market research system. Now, what are the areas in which market research could be conducted? It could include product research, the marketing mix, all the marketing mix could be researched upon, which includes product, price, place, promotion, and even the remaining three P's. So this is marketing research. Now, one important aspect that you need to understand here is the difference between marketing information system and marketing research, because this is normally a widely misunderstood area. There is only a thin margin of difference between the two. Now, the primary and the most important difference between marketing information system and market research system is, in marketing information system, after analyzing, gathering data, it is being further used for the purpose of decision making. Now, if you remember, when we discussed about the concept of marketing information system, we said the important function or the most important keyword in the concept of MKI is this: facilitate decision making. Now, that may or may not happen in research. What is the purpose of research? Research is to gather data, collect, sort, analyze, and interpret, give meaningful information. But marketing information system will not stop with that. It further facilitates the decision making process. In other terms, you can say marketing research is a part of marketing information system. So that's the difference. Now, we move on to the last component of marketing information system, the fourth component being the decision support system. Now, as the term suggests, decision support system, it is used at times when some contingency arises. There are a lot of instances in the organization where the organization cannot afford to go for a research, conduct a detailed research, and then have meaningful information out of it, interpret meaningful information and then make a decision. There are times when the organization will have to make immediate decisions. That decision could be because of some contingency, some ad hoc decisions which are being made, which are not routine in nature. So when you talk about reports itself, there are two types. One is a routine report and one is which happens during exception reports. So now ad hoc decisions, in order to make ad hoc decisions, decision support system comes into picture. Now let us say there has been a fire broke out in the factory. That is a contingency situation. So what to do at that point of time? So the famous case study of Nokia and Sony Ericsson, how they battled with the situation of a fire which broke out in one of the prominent predominant suppliers for these two organizations. Royal Philips, where a fire broke out in the Royal Philips factory, Nokia was able to easily deal with it, whereas Sony Ericsson was delayed a little, and then because of the procrastination or because they were not up to date about the damage, how much of devastation has happened, Sony Ericsson had to take a back seat. So this is an example of a contingency situation that arises, which calls for the application of decision support system. So to sum up what we have learned under components of marketing information system, the first component being internal sources, internal system. Then the second component being external system, which in which marketing intelligence is a part. So marketing intelligence system. The third component being market research system. And the fourth component being decision support system. So now under internal system, it includes information from customer, vendor, the sales data, financial data, the credit data, etc. Second, under the second component, external sources, in which marketing intelligence is a part, it includes database, which could be free or paid. Paid, under paid, we have seen the example of Lexis. Under free, we have seen the example of Census. Then syndicated research, we have already seen the example of Nielsen research, JD Pass. Then industry level data, where industries or organizations would provide the data. So see, Confederation of Indian Industries is one example. Then marketing intelligence, which primarily talks about competitor information in the form of environment scanning or garbology. Next, the third component, market research system, which talks about the various research being undertaken by organizations in order to have a detailed understanding. So customer satisfaction, customer abandonment, which customer should be retained, which customer should be abandoned. Then data mining into the market, various research areas like the product, pricing, promotion, distribution, etc. And then on the basis of the collected information, a report is being made. So the report could be of two types, progress reports or exception reports. Next, the fourth component of marketing information system, decision support system, which is primarily used for at the time when there is a contingency, when some ad hoc decision has to be made, which is not routine in nature. We have seen the example, we have seen a case study of Nokia, Sony Ericsson, when a fire broke out in Royal Philips plant, which was a prominent supplier for these two organizations, and how Nokia had an upper hand because they were up to date with the information. Now one example of how decision support system decisions can be taken is the Excel statistical package.
We have seen a very important concept today, marketing information system. Despite several developments having happened in the marketing information system, it is still in the nascent stage. There are a lot of developments that are happening. So now big data analytics, marketing analytics are all part of marketing information system, where meaningful information is being derived out of various decisions, out of various information that has been obtained. Now I'll just wind up the class with one practical example of how marketing information system finds application. Now, I hope you have heard of the concept of market basket analysis. Market basket analysis. Even if you haven't heard of this particular term, I'm sure everyone who is listening to me at this point of time would have tried purchasing a product through some of the e-commerce platforms like Amazon or Flipkart. Now, once you're selecting, trying to make a purchase through the Amazon platform or Flipkart, some of the e-commerce platform, you've selected a particular product and you're about to make a purchase. There are some suggestions which will come somewhere at the bottom of the page or somewhere at the side, asking you to try. You may also be interested in this particular product, this array of products. The features of the product, everything is given. So this is a classic example of market basket analysis. This is again an application of marketing information system where the customer analytics is done, customer preference is understood by the system and suitable search results are shown to the customer. So I hope marketing information system, the concept is very clear. Do not forget what I've told you in the beginning of the session. Spend some quality time with your family. Render a helping hand to your father, mother, sibling at home. Spend quality time with your family. Wishing you the very best.